Hey, Hatch. Leonard Hatch. Hatch.
If you're addressing me, sir, the name is Kublai Khan.
Oh, excuse me, Mr. Khan. Luncheon is served.
In Xanadu did I a stately pleasure dome decree. And there, from force of habit, I only dine with royalty.
Your Majesty, your nights await you.
And my days as well.
Thing for.
Beautiful.
Ain't nothing beautiful about no snake except the hole you bury him in. Oh, look at that. It's one of my best hens, Doris May. That's a shame, Doris May. I mean, that's just a shame. Thank you.
our newsroom. Patient Leonard Hatch escaped from Boston's Northfield Mental Hospital early this morning and is believed to be still in the area. This man should be considered dangerous. 5'9", slender build, blue eyes, 35 years of age.
Shot a rattler, Pa.
Clean out the hen house?
No, not yet. I was just getting started with the rattler, okay?
What time did that fella bring you back last night?
About 11.
After doing what?
You know, this and that.
Don't give me none of your this and that. You go sashaying out of here in clean jeans, smelling like bubble gum. To go to movies?
We did go to the movies, Pa.
What movie?
I don't know the name, but I didn't get there till after it started. It was all about this lady who hated this guy, and well, when she went to kill him, she realized she felt sorry for him and ended up in a clinch.
I'll bet you did.
Bet I did what?
Ended up in a clinch.
I'm talking about the movie, Pa.
And I'm telling you, girl, any boy around here lays a finger on you, I'll shoot him.
It was Carl Smathers' boy, Hank.
That make him any different? They're all after the same
Smathers
thing.
Smathers owns a general store.
Yeah, what has Smathers ever done for us except overcharges for those special order grape curtains?
But what else did I ever get for this house in the last 16 years? And then I never did get the curtains that I wanted.
You did too.
I did not. I wanted curtains with grape leaves. Not grapes.
What'd you do after the movies?
Simple than grape. Grape leaves.
Showed me how to throw his knife. The light weren't too good, so went down by the river and went fishing.
He didn't try nothing?
Well, stop chewing at her.
Look, I ain't raising no tramp around here.
Well, just because it's all you ever went out with before you met me, ain't no sign that all girls are a bunch of tramps.
I don't remember you giving me much trouble. I hadn't known you 10 minutes before you were talking about your appendix being took out.
Can go and wash off on the hen house.
After you finish with the hen house, I'll be mending fence over by the cattle guard. Go into town, get me some wire at Charlie's, and pick up a bag of peat moss while you're at it.
Got a bag. Wasn't brought up to live this way. Just think of all the things we'd have had if we stayed in St.
What would they have been?
Better than living on a dirt farm, I can tell you. I had my pickup. Several eligible bachelors.
I ain't gonna worry about that. So I wouldn't have been me.
What'd you say?
Well, I'm saying if you'd married one of them bachelors, I would have had different genes and chromosomes. But I got yours and Pa's, so I'm me, and I ain't gonna worry about it.
Where'd you learn that kind of dirty talk? You learn talk that way from Hank Smathers, aren't you?
All he's taught me is how to throw a knife.
Don't sass me, Doris May. Genes. Chromosomes. They make babies. Good Lord knows we don't need no more of them around here.
Well, that's something else I ain't gonna worry about.
And prosper.
Hey, Harry.
Hi, Kel.
Hi, Don. How's business?
Oh, so-so. Making a buck. How's by you?
I shot me rattler this morning.
No kidding.
Yep. Oh, must have been 5 or 6 feet long. Big.
5-6 feet. Skin like that ought to bring maybe 50, 60 bucks. You know how to cure it? You nail it to a board, scale side down, then you rub it with salt.
Rub it in good. You gotta have lots of salt, rub it in real good.
Get it way down into the skin, then you take it and you lay it out in the sun to dry, maybe a week or so. Hey, you want I should handle it? I could handle it for you. Only take maybe 5%. Would get us a good price from a couple of passing pale faces, huh?
Yeah. But guess what?
What?
My ma chopped it up.
Wax.
Hey, DM. How's the world treating you?
I don't know. Same as usual.
She shot a 6-foot rattle this morning.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You know how to cure it?
I did that bit already. Only your ma cut up the merchandise.
No, no. Did you keep the rattle?
That I got.
What you got?
Yeah. Now, how's that?
Whoa.
8, 10, 11, 12. That was a big mama. Real beaut. You keep hold of that. It'll bring you good luck.
Yeah?
Yeah. And the next time somebody chops up a snake of yours, you give a holler and I'll come out there and I'll knock a couple of heads together.
Okay.
You
thank
got that?
You. Yep,
yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's all over there now.
Put your bar down, too.
Oh, white, white, crawling.
Come on,
okay.
Come on.
Okay,
look,
there it is.
Man, I'll take off all your clothes, you hear me?
What?
Your clothes, take them off. I don't want you following down the street when I leave here.
Hey, what is this plastic pea shooter you
that's
got?
It's a killer gun.
Hey, that thing's going to blow the hole
it's
out of
a killer
daisy.
Gun, buddy. Don't mess with me.
Come
get
on,
away from me.
Punk. Get the money
get
back here.
No,
be no
here
trouble. Come on.
How you been?
All right.
I saw your truck out here.
Yep.
Need a hand with that?
I can manage.
Hey. I had a good time last night. How about you?
Well, I'm glad you had yourself a good time. I'll be getting home. You know my car.
Say, I heard you shot yourself a 7-foot rattler this morning.
God, since all this town has talked about some damn snake.
She was young and kind of pretty, with the look of someone lost. He was running from the city to be free at any cost. They were like strangers on a carousel. The world was all outside, and they were waiting for the starting bell to take them on a ride. He was angry when he caught her as she tried to run away. He grew softer then and taught her things that made her want to stay. They were like strangers on a carousel, a frightened boy and girl, two lonely strangers on a carousel made giddy by the world.
What's the problem? Run out of gas?
Listen, I ain't that stupid. Bust my dumb water hose.
You want a lift?
Well, I'm just headed up the road a couple miles.
Hop in, I'll take you.
With your surroundings?
Well, I can think of better places.
Such as?
St. Louis.
Why St. Louis?
I don't know.
stone school?
Got kicked out.
Oh, really? Why?
Punch a teacher.
You know, you could get away from here if you wanted to.
Are you kidding? My pa shoot me.
What does your pa do?
Rancher. Well, at least he was before the hook in the mouth. And I don't know what you call him, except a maybe farmer. He raises chickens. He's got me doing most of the work anyway. That's why he'd shoot me if I took off.
But you'd like to leave, wouldn't you?
What you'd like's got nothing to do with nothing.
On the contrary, my lady. What you'd like is the beginning of everything.
That's my turn coming up ahead there. Better start slowing down. Hey, mister, that's my turn back there.
Stop it! Be quiet. Sit back and relax. Don't panic.
Jump out now. You'll only succeed in hurting yourself. Just relax and nothing will happen to you.
What do you mean? It's happening.
You said you wanted to get away, didn't you?
Well, where are you taking me to?
Xanadu!
You're nuts.
Your formal education resumes presently, my lady. We're out. The sacred river runs through caverns measureless to man down to a sunless sea. But oh, that deep romantic chasm, a savage place, as holy and enchanted as ere the waning moon was haunted by woman wailing for a new lover.
Hey, why don't you just let me out? Look, I swear I ain't gonna tell nobody.
Anybody.
Look, if you're gonna rape me, why don't you just stop somewhere and do it? Then you can drop me back on the road and be on your way, okay? Well, what are you going to do with me then?
If you just relax, you might find it a rewarding experience.
Well, how long is it going to take, this rewarding experience?
That, my lady, depends entirely on you.
What's that?
That's Alf, the sacred river. Haven't you ever seen the river before?
No.
And I'll bet you've never been in the mountains either.
I've only seen them.
Oh, my lady. The river is from melted snow, from the fountains and the caves, the sunny pleasure dome with caves of ice.
So what kind of pleasure you got in mind? I got a right to know what to expect, don't I?
The only pleasure there is, my lady. And it's all in the mind.
Welcome to Xanadu.
How like you this place?
They probably found my pa's truck and they're out looking for me right now.
Of course they are, but they'll never find you up here. Whoever built this cabin came and went on horseback. I haven't seen a soul up here in 2 months.
Well, I bet they use helicopters and everything.
I don't flatter yourself. Ah! Wait a minute. Wait. Would you like some assistance? Help! Help! Oh, help! Help! Oh, help! No, don't go that way. It's booby trap. Are you all right? Now, listen to me, young lady. I don't want to have to keep telling you this, but any trouble you get into around here will be entirely your own fault. 3 more feet and you could have broken your neck. Now, you told me you weren't stupid. Kind of get on your feet and start proving it.
You sure don't take any chances, do you?
One never knows when one's being followed.
Thought you said no one's been up here in 2 months.
No one's been here yet. But you never know when someone might show up.
Why? Someone after you?
not loaded, so don't get any ideas.
I was just looking for the toilet.
The what?
Bathroom. You got one, don't you? Bathroom? Toilet? John? Comprende? No?
Stay on this path whenever you leave the cabin, you hear? The woods are all booby-trapped.
I bet.
You know what a booby-trap is, don't you? I say you know what a booby-trap is, don't you?
Yes, I know.
Well, from now on, you answer me when I ask you a question.
Well, whose fault is it? Truck broke down.
All kinds of peculiar people around here. They're all looking for the same thing.
Yeah, she was asking
for it. The truck broke down.
She was probably afraid to come home knowing what you do to her.
Yeah, now it's my fault she's missing.
I didn't say it was your fault.
Well, what did you say?
I'm saying the girl's got to have some other kind of life besides chores and cleaning your hen.
You gonna listen to that all the way in?
Yeah. When did you see DM leave?
About a half hour after we talked.
Alone?
Yeah. Going like a bat.
Is anybody following her?
No. Where do you think she is?
What's going on in there?
What do you think's going on?
Come on, I ain't saying you can stay in here all day. Let's go. Hey, close the door.
You sure don't believe in privacy, do you?
Let's go. You know who that is?
No.
Steve McQueen. Come on, let's get this show on the road.
Look, Sam, this ain't gonna be no road show. I got an APB out all over the county and the state. And a lot of questions to ask right here in town. So why don't you take that thing home before somebody gets hurt?
How's your cooking?
My what?
Your cooking. You can cook, can't you?
Of course I can cook.
Good then, my lady. Wilt thou avail thyself here and prepare something?
Oh, what would you like? I've got peanut butter, applesauce, jelly beans.
Don't mock me, damn it! Invent something! Make something up! Have you no imagination? Imagination turns food into cuisine. And tonight, you're entertaining royalty. This night, my lady, you are dining with the Raja of Sarawak.
Who?
The Bharini of Kush Bihar. The Emir Aliman. And the Lion of Judah.
You ever been to any of them places?
Those places, my lady. Them is not an adjective. It's the dative case of they.
You ever been to any of those places?
Of course, I know them all, and more. I know the world, the stars, the tide. I know the wind and the rain, the snow and the sleet. I know what makes the crocodile weep, and the leopard change its spots. I know the bank whereon wild thyme blows, where oxlip and the nodding violet grows, quite all canopied with thick, luscious woodbine, sweet musk roses and eglantine. And I know you're not listening to me.
It's because I don't understand what you're talking about.
Because you're not listening to me. The Raja of Sarawak is ready to dine. You may be seated.
Hungry.
Please, miss, the Raja never dines alone. Bon appetit.
Thank you, Basil.
digging.
In fact, it's quite excellent. Won't you join me? You know, there's nothing more lonely than the feeling you're talking to a blank wall.
Yeah, well, there's nothing more awful than being yelled at all of a sudden.
Quid pro quo. I shall try to control my temper.
I'll try to listen better.
What is your name, please?
Doris May Withers.
Doris May Withers. Do you like it?
I never thought about it much.
Henceforth, you shall be known as Krista Bell.
Who?
Christabel. A little child. A limber elf. Singing and dancing to itself. A fairy thing. Red round cheeks. That always finds but never sees.
You sure know a lot of poetry.
Poetry, my lady, is the escape of genius.
Well, you gotta admit, it sounds kind of funny sometimes. Stuff like whale moons, crocodiles and flowers, dancing fairies, crazy stuff like that.
So you were listening. But you don't understand. No, of course not. I think this is going to take a little time.
What is? How long are you going to keep me up here?
Are you really in such a hurry to get back to your chicken?
What's so hot about this place?
Do you have a boyfriend? Kind of an answer is hot.
Me with a boyfriend? What if I did? What difference does that make? What are you going to do with me anyway? Some crazy experiment?
I'm still waiting for an answer.
What was the question?
Do you have a boyfriend?
No! I don't know what people get so steamed up about anyway.
About what?
About boyfriends, dating, going all the way. Sex.
Congratulations, my lady. That's the first intelligent thing I've heard you say.
What did I say?
The subject was the unimportance of sex.
Well, I didn't say it weren't important. I just said I don't know why people make it important.
Wasn't, not weren't. Sex is singular. But your point is well taken. There may be hope for you yet, Christabel.
What happens now?
We're going to bed.
Gotta go to the bathroom.
You just went.
No, I didn't. I was scared and I just had to have me think.
If you lied to me before, how do I know you're not lying to me now? How do I know you're not going to try to escape?
What am I supposed to go to up here in the middle of the night?
Stay on the path, Diogenes. Remember, the woods are all booby-trapped.
We'll be right back.
ragged shadows of mossy leafless boughs, kneeling in the moonlight to make your gentle vows. Mr. Bell.
Get on your feet.
I can't. I hurt my foot.
You're lucky you're alive. Get on your feet.
You really are crazy.
Don't you ever say that to me again. Is that clear? I warned you about the traps, but you wouldn't listen, would you?
Some sheriff. Probably watching the late news over at the pool hall.
Supper, Sam.
But how do you expect me to eat that?
Well, you always managed to fill your face when she shoved it in front of you.
She makes it better.
Who do you think taught her?
Well, you taught her all right. Taught her to run off, most likely. Filling her head with fancy notions.
And now you're blaming me? Would you ever stop to think that she just might have got into trouble right here?
What do you mean?
Something she said on her way out.
Well, what'd she say?
Something about babies. About not having no babies around here.
Oh, you taught her real good. Taught her about fretting and begetting, and now she's gone and done it, and you let her go.
I let her nothing. Now, you were the one who sent her into town out the fence wire and... All she meant to you was a bunch of...
Look,
a
if that
Jeff Bennett drops
by playing sheriff... You tell him I'm out rounding up some real help from Mike and Robbie Fulton.
Now I sure don't get you. A little while ago, you wouldn't have cared if you'd killed me. Now you're tending me like a baby. Whose side are you on anyway?
I never said I wanted to kill you. This is my castle. And those booby traps are my moat.
You sure talk like someone's after you. I bet you done something.
Did, not done. But anyway, such as?
Well, maybe I'm not the first girl you've had up here.
It might interest you to know, young lady, that when I first saw you, I thought you were a boy.
Well, now I get it.
Get what?
You're
What? A shrewd and knavish sprite that heavy wanderer of the night called Robin Goodfellow.
Stop it! There you go, darling, funny again. I just don't get you. Sitting up here in the shack in the mountains, me and your poetry, afraid somebody's sneaking up on you. What's going on?
Most exciting adventure of your life, Christabel.
Stop calling me that.
You're beginning to use your mind.
Oh, like hell I am. I'm just sitting up here with a busted ankle.
Sprained ankle.
Locked in.
All the locks are beginning to open.
What about the booby traps?
I explained that. Now listen to me, please. Do you know what the mind is?
Well, I suppose it's the brain.
A fish has a brain. But does it have a mind? Do you think a fish can reason or judge a good book from a bad one?
Well, I ain't that dumb. I know fish can't read.
No, of course not. Fish is nothing but a mass of reflexes, right?
What about a porpoise? I saw a movie once where they taught a porpoise how to jump through a hoop.
Porpoise isn't a fish. It's a mammal.
Then it has a mind?
No, dear. I'm talking about the mind of man. That which sets him above all other creatures. His ability to reason, to judge, to appreciate. And the capacity of the human mind is limited only by the determination of its owner to improve it. Do you follow?
No, I still think a porpoise has a brain if it can jump through a hoop.
Can a porpoise split the atom, fly to the moon, build a cathedral? No, of course not, but man can because he has a mind. And so, my lady, do you.
Well, I don't care about doing that kind of stuff.
Right, but there are things you do want to do. You wanted to leave home this morning. You told me so yourself with exquisite simplicity. I can think of better places, quoth she.
Well, half the folks in the countryside have said that.
Yes.
And that's where their minds have stopped. But you, my lady, you can be anything you want to be.
Like what?
Anything at all, you name it.
Come on.
No, go on, try it just once. Who would you like to be?
Queen of England.
Your Majesty! I am Sir Francis Drake, your humble servant, at your command. We spur your most private passion, your most trifling whim, and it shall be satisfied. Good Queen Bess, I prithee, use me at thy will. You see? You see what happens when you want something?
It just gives me the creeps. I like you better when you talk like a normal person.
So you admit you do like me?
Well, I didn't mean it that way.
So you don't like me?
Well, I just think you're kind of weird.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, perhaps I'm going too fast for you. What to do, what to do? Don't go away. Let me think. I'll put me chinking cap on. It works every time. Ah, now tell me, lass. If you could have any wish in the world, anything at all right now, what would it be?
I'd like to be home my own bed.
Ah, are you telling me now that you'd like to spend the rest of your life tending chickens?
Well, you didn't ask me that. Yes.
Yes, what? You'd like to spend the rest of your life tending chickens?
Yes.
I don't believe you.
No, I don't care.
Oh, of course you do.
No, I don't.
Come along, you do.
Cut it out.
What is it now?
What would your wish?
No. I asked you first.
Oh, I don't know. A movie star.
A movie star? And why?
Because they just make lots of money. They don't do any work. They just sit around and look good. Now, what would your wish be? I told you mine.
No.
Yes, now, I told you mine, so you've got to tell me yours. Come on. You're not playing fair.
I'm not, am I? Would you really like to know? I'd like to leave something behind when I go. Something grand, beautiful. Something people would remember me by. Looking for the shells, I keep them in a pot here by the jars. You didn't use your head. You didn't follow through. You barred the door and you left the window open. No. I don't think you want to see either one of us get hurt. For trying. At least you wanted something enough to try for it. But in this case, I'll admire you even more when you accept the inevitable.
What's the inevitable?
Inevitable is what's going to happen to you now, whether you like it or not.
Oh, no. I shan't tie my hands up. I can't stand to tie my hands. I have no place. Look, oh, please, I'll do anything you want, please. Look, I'll even try to be inevitable. You can call me Christabel, please.
Well, all right, Christabel. But one more stunt out of you like that, and I'm hog-tying you to the table the rest of the week. Is that clear? Now, who is that?
John Wayne.
Right.
Good night. Till it be morrow.
Aren't you gonna try anything?
Try what?
Well, you know, SEX.
I thought we dispensed with that topic.
What do you think people get so steamed up about?
Because they don't use their heads. It's merely a biological function common to all animals.
What about porpoises? Do they get all steamed up about it, too?
I would imagine they tend to put it in a better perspective.
Perspective? What's that?
That means they're more relaxed about it. Now, go to bed.
And they're smarter than people.
I didn't say that. You don't have to be smart to be relaxed. Now, go to sleep.
Boy, Hank Smathers is smart, but he sure ain't relaxed.
So, you do have a boyfriend?
He's not my boyfriend. Just a guy taught me how to throw a knife.
And, what is it he isn't relaxed about?
Oh, I don't know. Sometimes I get the feeling that there's lots that I don't know. Maybe I am kind of stupid.
Oh, no, you're not.
I'm not?
No, Christabel. You have a very fine mind.
I do?
Yes, you do. Go to sleep.
I'm sorry.
Around while
well,
I might as well fix this place up.
It
looks like a hen house.
My wife wants you as a
tidier. Where is she now?
Dead. I killed her.
And how'd you do that?
Ah, you're curious, aren't you?
Who wouldn't be about that? Maybe that's what you did. You buried her up there, and that's what those booby traps are. They're all a bunch of graves. Maybe that's why the people.
Killed her up here in my mind.
And she's not really dead?
Dead as far as I'm concerned.
What were you bearing up there just now?
I was repairing the trap that you broke during your attempted escape last night.
You always talk with your mouth full. We could use a few more things around here, too, you know, like maybe a broom and a dustpan, some soap.
Make a list.
You mean you'll get the stuff?
Within reason, and kindly stop calling everything stuff.
And how about some towels and shelves and
Some curtains would go nice.
Oh, and what about wall-to-wall carpeting, an electric dishwasher, color TV?
Look, I ain't that dumb. I can see there ain't no electricity and plumbing.
Isn't any electricity or no plumbing? I mean, you know what I mean.
And how about some good food instead of this crummy stuff you've got up here?
Oh, and what would she like?
Well, I would like some hot dogs, some potato salad, apples, milk, some french fries. And how about some Ortiz hot chili
peppers? And just how does she propose we keep this banquet from spoiling?
Well, we can put the stuff that spoils in a burlap bag and put it in the river. Can't we? Here, put the sack on your head. It'll make you dizzy, but it'll make them go away. Now, come on,
get away from me.
No, put this on your head.
Give me that.
Well, do you want me to do it, or do you want to do it?
Stay right there.
Put the sack on your head and breathe in deeply, and it'll make them go away.
The most ridiculous thing I've ever. Now, what do? I put this on my head and breathe?
Just put it on your head and breathe in deeply.
It's going to make me pass out, is it?
No, come on.
I got my eye on you. I put it over my head and I breathe deeply, yes. Get over there!
That's it. Just keep breathing deeply. Back me! How's it then?
Why did you do that?
Well, I got rid of your hiccups, didn't I?
Hey, anything new?
No.
I got customers. I'll see you later, right?
All right, Harry, take it easy.
And all should cry, beware, beware. His flashing eyes, his floating hair, weave a circle round him thrice. And close your eyes with holy dread, for he on honeydew hath fed and drunk the milk of paradise.
You read real good.
What, thank you.
That guy sounds just like you.
Oh, really? What else?
Well, I've been thinking.
What?
You know, some curtains would really cheer this cabin up.
Some what?
Some curtains.
Curtains?
Yeah.
Any particular kind, my lady?
Well, there's these neat white brocade ones with grape leaves, and it's got a fine gold thread running through them. They're really nice.
Yes, and just where am I supposed to acquire these curtains? The Casbah?
No, the dry goods store in town. And it's a common pattern. It kind of reminds me of home.
Oh, anything else to make you feel at home, my lady?
Well, bed wouldn't be a bad idea.
A bed? A bed? How about the hand-carved four-poster? Or better still, mademoiselle, how about the canopy divan with a Nubian slave to find your reforms and feed you chocolates on demand?
Well, I didn't ask to be here. I'm not even asking you for your dumb old mattress. Just trying to make the best of things. An army cot would be just fine.
Good, my lady. Now you're beginning to use your mind. What else? Say on.
A toothbrush.
Toothbrush.
Change of clothes.
Change of clothes.
Hairbrush.
Hairbrush.
Maybe a dress?
What?
A dress.
You think you're pretty clever, don't you?
What do you mean?
Sending me to a town where a girl is missing to buy a dress.
Stand up. Put your hands behind your back.
Why?
Because I said so.
I thought we agreed.
That was last night. It's 2 hours to town and 2 hours back.
Look, I promise. How could he be nice one minute and so mean the next?
Going into town to get these things for you. At least this way I know you'll be safe while I'm gone.
Look, if I'm such a bother, why don't you just drop me at home on the way? That's what all my boyfriends do. No, I was just kidding. I was wondering if you could leave the door open so I could have something to look at. Helps me use my mind.
Oh, by the way, the weapons are of no use. I have all the shells with me. Au revoir.
Withers come out to my place last night drunk with a shotgun saying, I done it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. What's all the commotion?
Oh, girl got kidnapped.
No kidding.
Yeah, they found her pickup halfway to her house yesterday morning. Nobody has seen her since.
Well, it doesn't necessarily mean she's been kidnapped. I mean, did anyone actually see her being abducted?
No. Some folks think she ran off, but I don't think so, and I knew her.
What did she look like? I mean, was she pretty?
Oh, muy bonita.
Muy bonita.
Bonita.
Yeah.
Well, I think she was about 17, I think. Average, not too tall. Hey, amigo, what color is her hair?
Well, you know, it's so dark, so... Well, you know, she always wore a hat.
Dresses like a boy, see? She had a Stetson and jeans and cowboy boots, you know, like...
Now, wait a minute. You know what? I may have seen this little girl myself yesterday.
When yesterday?
Around noon, just outside of town here. Little girl dressed like a cowboy sitting in the back seat of a big long limousine. It's possible it could be she, no?
You better tell Jeff.
Yeah, Jeff's gonna want to know.
Hey, wait a minute. Who's Jeff?
He's the sheriff. He has been going out of his gourd looking for her.
Now, look, I've got a long drive back home. You fellas can tell him for me.
You better tell her.
Please. You saw her. You tell her.
What kind of car? Well, I don't know much about cars, but it looked like a big, long, black limousine.
Did you notice the plates?
No, I'm sorry again, I didn't.
Was there anybody else in the car?
You mean besides the driver? You know, now that you mention it, I think there was a guy in the back seat with her, yes.
What side was the girl?
The left. She was on the left.
Did it look like she was being forced?
No, not at all. She just sat there staring straight ahead. Scrunched down a little, you know, like maybe she was trying to hide.
Uh-huh. Where were you?
Well, I was just 4 or 5 miles outside of town, heading in, and we crossed. They were heading toward Albuquerque.
Uh-huh. What's your name?
Me?
Mm-hmm.
Roger B. McDivitt, sir.
What's the B stand for, Roger?
Bananas. I'm only kidding. Bernard.
Where do you live?
Just off the main road toward Albuquerque.
What's your business?
I beg your pardon?
What kind of work do you do?
Oh, what I do for a living. Mm-hmm. I'm into farming a little, some welding. I'm a welder by trade.
Never heard your name.
Well, there's no reason you should. I mean, I'm in the other county, and I've only been around a few months.
Some coffee?
No, sir. No, thank you.
What were you doing in town yesterday?
I just came in to do some shopping and have a few beers. Why are you giving me the third degree?
Sounds like that, doesn't it?
Yes.
I'm sorry. I've been up all night. I've been racking my brain trying to put this thing together.
That's all right. I understand.
I appreciate your help, Mr. McDevitt. Well, listen, you got a phone out there?
No, I'm afraid not. Why?
Oh, just in case there's a couple of questions I forgot to ask you. I'll tell you what. If there is, I'll leave a message with Harry Fox at the garage across the street.
Oh, the Indian fellow?
Yeah.
Fair enough.
All right, thank you very much for your help.
Thank you, sir. Yeah.
Keep smiling.
I shall.
Give me Albuquerque.
Excuse me, sir. Do you have any Ortiz hot chili peppers?
Why do you want Ortiz?
Because I like them.
It's a special brand. Not too many people ask for them. You want me to order you some?
No. That's all. Thank you.
I can order them.
No, that's better.
No trouble.
These are swell. Oh, and I'd like one more shirt just like this one, only in a size smaller for my little brother. Okay?
How much smaller?
I guess about your size. Oh, and the cook would like toothbrush, hairbrush, and a dress.
Shopping for the whole family.
I'm sorry, what?
You doing the shopping for the whole family?
Yes, ma'am.
What size dress?
Size? 12?
Don't ask me. Any particular color?
Yeah, this one. Is this for sale?
You want to buy that dress for a cook?
If it's all right with you.
Crazy. I never heard of men buying women's clothes before.
There are no women. The cook just likes to dress up like one.
McDivitt, right?
Yeah, right.
Sheriff is looking for you.
For me? Why?
Well, just wanted to thank you. They found that guy.
What guy?
You know, the one that kidnapped the girl.
Oh, really?
Yeah, down in Albuquerque.
Oh, terrific.
They traced him through that car you spotted.
Oh, be darned.
Yeah, he took her to some motel down there.
Turned out to be a real sickie.
Well, you just never know, do you?
No, you never know. Well, anyway, Jeff, the sheriff, well, he ought to be halfway to Albuquerque right now on his way to pick him up.
Hey, well, listen, when he gets back, you tell him from me that any help I gave him was entirely my pleasure.
Yeah,
okay?
Sure, man. Right.
Bye-bye.
Oh, hey. Live long and prosper, man.
I shall. We'll see you later now. Good King Wenceslas himself, the Emperor of Ice Cream. Come on, give me a hand with this stuff.
What?
Now to my charge. For my lady's sweet slumber, one genuine canvas cot with enclosed pillow. And as my lady is a tidier of some note, one bona fide broom. Contained herein is toothbrush, hairbrush, towels, comb, various other sundries to engage thy vanity. Here we have sartorial splendor for obvious use. Contained in yon box is much food to thy fancy, etc., etc., etc.
Oh, you really got the works. Where'd you get the money for all this?
Modest inheritance, not to worry. But now what shall she wear to the ball? Come, let us conjure an appropriate garb.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Where's the act?
I suppose you're mad at me for not staying put.
I knew you'd untangle yourself.
Oh, you think you know everything.
Where's the axe?
Here, I suppose you'd be wanting this back.
You were going to stand behind the door in a chair and cleave me in two when I came in, weren't you?
Yes, did I?
Are you trying to deny you planned it?
Well, planning ain't the same thing as doing.
Morally, it's exactly the same.
Oh, come on. If they ever passed a law like that, half the people in the world go to jail.
How could you dream of killing me?
Well, figures don't.
Doesn't it?
You almost killed me.
I did nothing of the sort, and you know it.
Well, either did I.
Neither did you. I mean, well, maybe change your mind.
Well, I don't know.
Supposing I'd swung and missed.
You think it'll fit?
There's only one way to find out. Oh, don't close the door.
A lady's entitled to her privacy. Entirely different person?
Oh, I am. I'm the Queen of England. I'm a movie star. I'm Chris...
Come on, say it.
I'm Christabel. We have never eaten a spirit, Mom.
All we need now is some cigars and brandy. Emilio, por favore, portami un cigarro e una bottiglia di brandy. Bravo, bravo.
Hot dog.
Emilio, uno hot dog.
No, no, no.
No. What were you like as a boy?
As a boy? It's quite unbearable, I'm sure.
But what'd your friends think of you?
Friends, I didn't have many friends. In actual fact, I didn't have any at all.
How come?
Because... because my mother... I'm sure you wouldn't be captivated with the story of my blissful youth.
Yes, I would. Hey, do you want some dessert?
Stay me with flagons, comfort me with apples. Many a dangerous temptation comes to us in fine, gay colors, the frivolous fruit that first tempted Adam.
I thought you were really nuts, just like you thought I was really stupid. But we're not. Not really.
Japan?
What's that like?
Where, Japan? Oh, it's
It's like no place else you've ever seen. By boat, you come into the inland sea, and the land rises straight out of the water. The mountains are tall and craggy, and all the trees, they seem to grow sideways, and everything, absolutely everything, looks lacy.
I've never been anywhere but the dentist in Albuquerque. Where else you been?
Oh, the Caribbean.
Caribbean?
Yes. There, too, it's extraordinary. Sometimes at night, it's so calm. The sea, I mean. The stars are reflected right down to the wake of the ship. The horizon disappears, and you seem to be drifting through a huge bowl of stars. And the phosphorescence is like coal fire.
What's phosphorescence?
Phosphorescence. Ocean fireflies.
Talking to you in the dark. Tell me something else.
What?
Oh, I don't know. Anything.
Tomorrow.
Will you at least tell me one thing?
What?
What's your name?
What difference does it make?
So I can call you something besides hey.
Kubla Khan.
No, I mean your real name.
That is my real name. Christabel. I saw you taking a bath.
I know.
I mean, I was watching you. I just thought I should tell you so you wouldn't think of me as a voyeur.
I don't even know what a voyeur is. But you know something? You could use a bath too, n'est-ce pas? Tiger, tiger, burning bright in the forests of the night.
What immortal hand or eye could frame thy fearful symmetry?
Again?
Symmetry.
Symmetry?
What's that?
Symmetry. That's a perfect balance between two sides of the same thing. Example, the stripes on the back of a tiger, wings of a butterfly, the two sides of your face. Symmetry is beauty of proportion. Can you think of an example?
The Dimeback Rattler I shot.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it was sure beauty. Huh. I kept the rattle. I keep it with me all the time. It's supposed to bring me good luck.
Has it brought you good luck?
Well, I don't know yet. But it sure is beautiful.
I got something.
Party, of course, you got bombs.
The boys.
Merci.
Ain't you gonna hog tie me today?
Ain't you gonna give me a reason to?
I got the list.
Yo.
So I thought of something else.
What's that?
Well, we could have our own garden, grow our own vegetables. Soil's good. We could even have cows and chickens.
Cows?
Yeah.
Well, how many of them you think I can get in here?
Yeah. Well, we could have some goats. I even found a place we can go ice skating in the winter.
Okay. Yeah? I'll see what I can do by a couple of goats and some ice skates. How'd that be?
Okay. Anything's possible if you just think it through. Good luck. Have fun.
I shall in all my best obey you, ma'am. Adieu.
Sure.
Thank you. May I dispose of my garbage here?
In the can, man.
Merci, monsieur.
Hey, McDivitt, sheriff was looking for you.
Again? Why?
Search me. Just said if I was to see you to tell you to drop by.
Well, is it in relation to the kidnapping?
No, no. That was a false alarm.
Oh?
It turned out to be some cattleman from Nebraska, taking his daughter to a dude ranch.
Dear me, I imagine he was quite upset, eh?
Yeah, and how?
Well, it's not my fault, though, that he arrested the wrong man, is it?
No, didn't say it was. Now, you mind if I ask you a question?
Not at all, shoot.
Where are you from?
Now, what possible difference does that make?
No difference. Just some of the guys was wondering, that's all.
Why? Do I look so different from other people?
No, no, but you do speak different.
Do I?
Yeah.
Well, just so you and everyone else can sleep easier tonight, I'm from Massachusetts.
You were a farmer in Massachusetts?
Well, no, actually, I guess I did everything else but farming. See, I have this lung problem. My doctor advised me to come out here for my health. I do welding mostly, piecework, you understand?
Oh. Mind if I look at your license?
No.
Ah.
Oh, of course.
You know, this is no good.
I beg your pardon?
You're living here now. You shouldn't be driving on a Massachusetts license or Missouri plates.
I bought the truck in Missouri.
Well, that's what I figured. You get yourself licensed and registered here.
All right, sir, I will. Anything else, Jeff?
No, not that I can think of. All I need to know now is, where's the girl?
Any new leads?
The FBI thinks she's left the state. But me? I kind of like to think she's eloped.
Anything else?
Yes, I'd like some curtain material, please.
What kind?
A white brocade grape leaf pattern with a fine gold thread running through it.
Fine gold thread?
Yes, ma'am.
Sure. Wait a minute.
What was that pattern you wanted, sir?
It's a white brocade grape leaf pattern with a fine gold thread running through it. It's quite simple.
Well, not around here, it isn't. In fact, I've only had one order like that for the last 10 years. And even that customer had to settle for grape clusters.
Oh, well, obviously my wife was mistaken.
But no, I didn't say your wife was mistaken. I can special order for you, like I did for the other lady.
Who was the other lady?
Other lady?
Yes.
Mrs. Asa Withers.
Asa Withers?
Was the mother of the kidnapped girl.
Yes, of course.
Can I place that order for you?
You can indeed, yes.
What'd you say your name was?
McDivitt.
McDivitt. Now, if you wait here just a minute...
No. I'll take $20.
$20, don't you want a receipt?
No, I'll be back next week.
But it may not be done by next week.
Not to worry!
McDivitt, orderly at Northfield State Hospital for the insane, had his license stolen and a patient escaped. Named Leonard Hatch, age 31, 5'9", blue eyes.
You sent me into town to buy curtains. The same kind of curtains your mother has. The only other person who's ever even asked for them.
Well, how was I supposed to
know
that?
You did the same damn thing with the chili peppers the other day. Special order, you told me. You've been sending me to town all along with clues so they'd catch me. Admit it!
Why
did
you go for the curtains today? I didn't ask for them today. I asked for them 3 days ago.
What difference does it make?
What's the matter with you? Can't the big genius see? 3 days ago, I would have done anything to get away from here. Now, things change.
I've taught you to use your mind, all right. I've turned you into a fast-thinking shrew.
Okay, you tell me. How come I didn't try to get away from here the other day when I got loose? Or why didn't I leave today? How come I washed your clothes and picked you fresh flowers and tried catching you a fish? I even baked you an apple brown Betty in a cruddy old saucepan. Does that sound like someone trying to escape or someone trying to trick her guy into getting caught? I even had a nice surprise for you, but just forget it.
What is it?
Oh, never mind. It's too late.
Tell me what it is.
I wrote that damn poem.
Show it to me. There's nothing in one of your old groceries.
I'll turn it over.
I can't read your chicken scratch. You read it.
Cabin of the Dawn. By Doris May Withers. The truck broke down when I was on my way home. Then along came a man speaking in poems. I thought he was nuts when he called himself Kubla Khan, and he took me away to his cabin of the dawn. At first I thought I was in a terrible mess, but he's made me a lady, even bought me a dress. He taught me all sorts of things from the very start. He opened my mind and gave wings to my heart. First, I just couldn't figure this funny man out. But then I realized he's teaching me what life's all about. Like wanting things enough can make them come true. I guess that's what he means by Xanadu. Life on that farm was almost like hell. Now I'm Queen of England. My name's Christabel. We dine on delicacies and plenty of fruit. Then I dance for him as he plays me his flute. I think he's been awfully lonely a while. and just needs a friend at whom he can smile. What he doesn't know is he's got one in me. And together we make awful nice symmetry. It's me. Being smart in Panasco.
What good indeed, my lady.
Actually, though, it's getting dark. Maybe we should wait till night.
But there'll be roadblocks.
We could go the other way, up over the mountains on foot to Mexico.
All right. Start packing your things.
Hold me. I'm scared.
No, don't be scared. Don't be scared. We'll try for Mexico.
Better get ready to go now. Go with music sweet and loud, and take two steeds with trappings proud, and take the one thou lovest best to play thy harp and learn thy song, and clothe thee both in solemn vest, and over the mountains haste along. Oh my God, that's a number 7 trap. They're here.
Manhattan, this is Sheriff Jeff Emmett. We know you're in there. Send the girl out alone. You will not be harmed.
Then you come out backwards with your hands on your head.
Get down! No, no, no. It's not the way to do it. You gotta use your hand.
But they can't do anything if I want to be with you, can they?
Who the hell fired that child?
Get a fireplace, come on.
Stay with us for our second movie for your Tuesday afternoon here on Five. A pampered Tinseltown star drops out of the limelight and heads to a small town in New England. In the romantic drama Catch a Falling Star, coming up after a quick Five News update with Kirsty Young.